Do Pakistani Hindus still cross over, sir, into Jaipur and other places, into
Yes.
Rajasthan, other places? And what is their plight currently, sir? Or will there be some kind of effect of the Afghan trauma on the Hindus here in Pakistan?
There'll be a huge impact, Sudhakar bhai, because the Afghan Pashtun people's migration into Pakistan is going to create a pressure on the economy of Pakistan, which is already on the brink of collapse. And the biggest sufferers will be Hindus and Sardars, because they are the lowest in this pyramid. They will be crushed. Already one video per day is coming out on Twitter and in social media by Pakistani Hindus and Pakistani Sardars and Pakistani Christians, and the horrors they are facing with their daughters being lifted up. About 5 days ago, there was a video in which the 14-year-old Meghwal Hindu girl was raped in front of her parents and taken away. So the situation unfolding in Afghanistan will open new horrors for Pakistan and Sardars of Pakistan, Hindus and Sardars of Pakistan. Are Hindus from Pakistan still coming over? No. From March 2020, not one Hindu has been able to come to Bharat because of the corona lockdown. The Indian government has sealed the borders. The Indian embassy is practically shut in Islamabad. We are not giving visas to any more Pakistani citizens. As and when the COVID situation improves, as and when the borders open, I'm sure the Pakistani Hindu influx to India will resume. Close to 1 crore Hindus and Sardars are living in that forbidden land, and it is my life's mission that every single Hindu and Sardar has to be taken out of that hellhole.
But why is it that the government officials are very lax when it comes to the implementation or the unfoldment or enrollment of the CAA? What could be the reason, and why is the government not trying to rein in the bureaucracy and then speed up the whole process?
I wish I could answer that, Sudhakar bhai. But this question is as generic as asking that why are we corrupt? Why are we lazy? Why does money make us go bonkers? Why do we sell our atma to traitors of this nation? These questions have no answers. We can only beg, we can only pester, we can only plead to the government of India that for Shiva's sake, for Kali's, Maa Jagdamba's sake, please listen to the woes of these Hindus and Sikhs trapped in Pakistan and Afghanistan, and please increase the number of visas from 2,000 to 5,000. These Hindus will be killed in the next 10 years. It is not rocket science to deduce that. It is very simple. The facts are glaring us in our faces. But an apathetic bureaucracy and lackluster will, we are, in spite of Modi ji's mammoth step to pass the CAA, I think it was a path-breaking moment for Indian legislature, for Hindu civilization. It was a civilizational step when we passed the CAA in the Lok Sabha and the Rajya Sabha. And then getting stuck up in a bureaucratic hurdle or due to some international pressure, I don't know. I have no idea why this is happening, but we can only beg to this government that please speed up the implementation of CAA so that it sets up an example and they're able to take out as many Hindus and Sardars before more daughters are lost, before more lives are lost, before more businesses are lost.